So I've been going through the speakers list ever since it was out, and one thing that stood out was that I'm like the youngest speaker here today. So I think this photo over here describes me very well. So it's a great honor to share the stage with some of my role models, and it would not be an understatement to say that I'm here to just hear these guys speak. I come before you as a cat amongst giants, and I hope you will forgive any mistakes that I made. So you're probably wondering, who is this guy? And introducing myself, my name is Samir Deshmukh, also known as Wardro on GitHub and Twitter. I come from the incredible country of India, which is home to the lonely deserts of Rajasthan, the serene and snowy Himalayas, the emeralds in the Indian Ocean that are the Lakshadweep Islands, and the monument that is described as a teardrop on the cheek of time, the Taj Mahal. Specifically, I'm from the city of Pune, which is a city of about 6 million people. It's also known as the Oxford of the East because of around 2 million students who are studying in the city in about 700 colleges. So I'm also an undergraduate student in computer engineering at the University of Pune. Most of my family has mostly consisted of doctors. In fact, my great-grandfather was a doctor. My grandfather is a doctor. My father is also a doctor, but somehow I turned out to be an engineer and looked like this not too long ago. I also play in a band called Cat Kamikaze. You can check out our music on SoundCloud. I also love cats, and I like the Japanese too, so it's Cat Kamikaze. I am on the core team of the Ruby Science Foundation, so also known as SciRuby. The Ruby Science Foundation is committed to making Ruby a viable language for data science and scientific computing, which is something that Ruby has been lacking in for a while now. It's very popular for web development, but not in this domain as much. So we basically make tools and infrastructure and open source libraries for this purpose. I was first introduced to SciRuby as a summer intern for Google Summer of Code 2015. Later that year, I also received the Ruby Association grant from the Ruby Association. And this year, I'm an admin for DSOC 2016. I'm administering managerial duties for SciRuby and also mentoring a student for improving data science tools in Ruby. So my talk for today will be scientific computing in Ruby. In this talk, we'll go over a few tools that you can use in Ruby for data science and scientific computing. And I will follow up my slides with a short demo of these tools. The first tool that we'll go through is called the iRuby Notebook. iRuby is a browser-based Ruby REPL shell that is mainly used for interactive computing. So this is what an iRuby Notebook looks like. As you can see, it's running in your browser. And there's an input shell in which you can put in Ruby code, and it renders it very nicely in the form of HTML, JavaScript, or CSS. You can also put in a form inside the notebook, and you can accept input from users, which you can use for input into any Ruby script that you have in the notebook. The next gem is called nmatrix. Nmatrix is an n-dimensional array object similar to NumPy in Python. It helps to interface Ruby with a few high-speed C libraries, such as Atlas or LAPACK for linear algebra calculations. So this is roughly what an nmatrix allocation looks like. Nmatrix is not a dynamic object like, say, Ruby's array, but it is of a fixed size. So in the first argument, I'm saying that the nmatrix should be of size 2 by 2, that's a 4 size n matrix. In the second argument, I'm specifying the actual elements. And then I want a matrix of 32-bit floating point numbers, so I specify the dtype option as float 32. So nmatrix supports 8 data types currently, ranging from 8-bit integers to 128-bit complex numbers. And it also has 3 storage types, 2 of which are sparse storage types, and one is the normal dense storage type. By itself, nmatrix is more of a Ruby wrapper over C arrays. But what makes it truly shine is that it exposes a very powerful C API, which can be used by anybody for interfacing these internal C arrays with a variety of high-speed C libraries. So you can basically create a plugin for nmatrix with nmatrix as a dependency and use this internal representation and the nmatrix API for creating your own plugins. Currently, we have plugins for four major libraries. Atlas and Lapack are mainly used for linear algebra. FFTW is for fast Fourier transforms. And the GNU Scientific Library, or GSL, as you know, has almost every mathematical function one can think of. Nmatrix is also coming to JRuby by August, and it will have the exact same API as the Nmatrix for MRI, and it will use JBLAST for linear algebra. The third library is called nyaplot. Nyaplot is an interactive plotting tool. It basically generates interactive HTML and JavaScript plots that run in your browser and let you interact with them. So this is a very simple sine wave plot generated by nyaplot. Nyaplot also sports a somewhat similar plugin-based architecture similar to nmatrix. It has MapNya for creating map visualizations, nyaplot 3D for three-dimensional objects, and BioNya for realizing relationships between genes. The fourth library is called Daru. So for most Rubies from all over the world, Daru stands for Data Analysis in Ruby, but in the national language of my country, that is Hindi, Daru also means alcohol. I hope Daru, the library, becomes as important to Rubies as Daru, the drink, is for Indians. I hope both of them become equally important at tonight's conference party. So Daru is basically a library for analysis and cleaning of data. You can say that it's primarily used for data scientists who are interested in analysis of data. It provides some powerful indexing functionality, and it also lets you read and write data from many different sources like CSV files, Excel files, SQL databases, and even Active Record. It works very well with wild data. So it so happens that almost 60% of a data scientist's time is spent in cleaning data and bringing it to the state that that can be analyzed by conventional means. And Daru tries to make this very simple by providing functions for doing that. It also has a lot of statistics functions which work with wild data as well. The libraries that I portrayed right now, nyaplot, iRuby, and nmatrix, Daru is able to leverage these libraries for things like efficient storage of data, visualization, and interactive computing. So Daru primarily performs its functions via two data structures. The first one is called a Daru vector. It's a one-dimensional heterogeneous array object, and each data point in the vector can be labeled independently with Daru's indexing functionality. The second object is called the Daru data frame. This is a 2D spreadsheet-like data structure that can be indexed both on rows and columns. I'll switch to my demo now. So this is an iRuby notebook. As you can see, you can put either Markdown or code over here. Now I'm going to create a form. So I can put in the number of rows that I want for a matrix, say 4, columns 4, and I want the number to be 3 inside it. So it returned a hash, and I use this hash to create a matrix. There goes. A short demo of nmatrix. Now I want to create a 4x4 matrix consisting of 64-bit floating point numbers. So I specify the shape as 4x4, and I specify 16 elements over here. Now I want to create an nmatrix with 8-bit floating point, 8-bit integers. So just for demonstration purposes, I'll use 129 over here. If you store 129 in an 8-bit number, it will be reflected as -127. You can access any element in the nmatrix with a simple Ruby array-like API. So I want the 0th row and the 3rd column, so which is -127. You can also assign numbers. So 0, I throw in first column, I want it to be 56, I do that. But as I said, it cannot be expanded like Ruby array. So this gives a range error. Now I want to use the Atlas plugin for performing some fast computations, and we'll compare this with the Ruby matrix class for to know actually how much the speed actually increases. So let's benchmark this. Now over here I'm creating an nmatrix of these sizes 5 to 200, and I do a dot product on them for matrix multiplication. So let's benchmark this now. So as you can see, it's instantaneous. For size 200, the speed is 0.01 seconds. And I'm doing the exact same computation on nmatrix, on Ruby matrix, sorry. And the time turns out to be quite a lot. So as you can see, it's magnitudes faster for the same computation. Now let's do a small example where I'll solve a system of linear equations using nmatrix. By the way, you can also use iRuby notebook to represent LaTeX equations right in your browser like this. So I'm representing the coefficients of this equation this way in an nmatrix of 32-bit floating point numbers, and the right hand side in a matrix called RHS. Now I use the Atlas solve function, and it gives me the solution. Now let's head on to a demo of nyaplot. So now I want to plot a simple sine wave similar to the one that I showed in the presentation. Here I'm creating the data for the x and the y axis. I create a nyaplot plot object and add it to the line graph. And add a line graph to the plot object. So here goes. Now I want two waves on the same plot. So what I do is, I want a sine wave. I create data for that using the math sine function. And I want a cos wave, and I create the data for that with the math cos function. The sine wave should be a line plot, which I add with specifying the line option. And the cosine wave should be a scatter plot, which I add with the scatter option. The color over here is red, and the color over here is green. So as I said, it's an interactive plotting tool. You can actually zoom into this graph. And if you hover your mouse pointer over one of these dots, it will show you the exact coordinates on the x and y axis. So now we want to plot two graphs which interact with each other and change according to input that you put into one graph. So let's create some hypothetical data. So I have four band names here. And I create a nyaplot data frame, which is an internal data structure for storing data. And I create, so there's a popularity between 0 and 100 assigned to a particular band in a particular country. Now I want to plot a histogram which has the popularity of each band, and this next plot that I want is a bar graph of the frequency of the number of times the band occurs in the data frame. So I just do it with add with df, and I add both these plots to the nyaplot frame. So as you can see, both these graphs have been displayed here. Now, what I want to see is the number of bands that have popularity between 0 and 20 in any country. So I can just select it this way. And as you can see, the bar graph has changed to reflect that. So if you see, megahertz is 3. And in order to verify that this is correct, let's filter this data frame. And you can see that megahertz occurs 3 times here, 1, 2, and 3. And each time the popularity is less than 20. So this bar graph actually reflects exactly that. So next up, we'll have a small demo of Daru. So the Daru index provides indexing functionality for the rest of the Daru data structures. I'm creating a very simple index over here. and you can select an element in the index with the box operator, or you can even select multiple indices by separating them with commas. So now you want to create a data frame. This is a very simple case of a data frame. I specify A, B, and C as the hash keys, and you can see that they've been reflected as A, B, and C as the names of the columns of the data frame. Indexing also supports more type of indexes called multi-index, datetime index, and categorical index. Multi-index is used for hierarchical indexing of data. So now over here I'm creating a multi-index with tuples. And I use this multi-index as for indexing data for this vector. So now I want to select the sub-indices of A, B. So I specified here, and I get CDP. And now I want the sub-indices of just A. So I specify A, and I get BQ, which is exactly what is here. So now the date time index is another index that is used for indexing data on timestamps. Here I'm creating a date time index from a range starting from the beginning of 2011 up to the end of 2013, separated by 3 days each. I create another hypothetical vector and I index it on the date time index. As you can see, each day over here is separated by 3 days. And now I want to select the data from 1st of January to the 10th of February, which can be done like this. As you can see, the last date is the 9th of February. Now I want all the dates in 2012. And now let's take a hypothetical data frame which has average temperatures of these given cities. And I want them to be ordered by name and temperature. So I specify the order option as name, temperature. And it needs to be sorted on the temperature. So I specify temperature as the argument to sort. Now data frame also has a where clause based querying syntax similar to ARIL or active record. And you can actually specify where data frame where the temperature is less than equal to 25, and it will show it to you instantly. Plotting is also very simple. So over here I'm specifying a bar graph, and the x-axis is the name and the y-axis is the temperature, and it gives me a graph. That's it for my demo, and I have cool SciRuby stickers, so you can come say hi to me and I'll give you a sticker. Yeah. And I'd like to thank RedDotRubyConf for having me over. This is the first time I'm stepping out of my country, and I was quite blown over by the amazing infrastructure of Singapore and the very hospitable and inviting nature of its people. So hats off to Singapore for being an amazing city, and hats off to you guys for being an amazing audience. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Samir. Any questions from the audience, please?
Hello, Asmia. I want to ask you one question about the nyaplot. You choose to use HTML and JavaScript to plot the diagram, but how is any other solution to plot the diagram in the back end, not just front end?
So it can export the diagram to either an SVG or a pure HTML, but if you export to an SVG, you won't be able to interact with it. So it will just be a static diagram.
So Samir, I have a question.
Yeah.
So regarding your scientific, do you do any scientific research with the libraries that you have just introduced just now?
I'm planning to.
Planning to. Do you have any suggestions for any of us that's simple to implement?
Well, you can start with the plotting.
Just plotting. Okay, yeah. Sure. Cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you.